We're going to begin by saying in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us, and lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen. So I'd like to welcome all of you who are joining with us this evening in this session for adult education in the Diocese of Paisley. I was delighted when Canon Michael McMahon asked me to give a presentation on prayer as part of the programme of adult education in our diocese. As Christians, there is nothing we do that is more important than making time for God and spending time with God in prayer. The volumes of books about prayer remind us that there's a great thirst among people to know more about prayer and to know how to pray. They also remind us that there's so much we can learn about praying as well as learning about techniques and methods of prayer. As this presentation is part of the annual formation in our diocese, then I would recommend that you read part four of the Catechism of the Catholic Church on Christian prayer. All the great saints throughout history and all the spiritual directors worth their salt say that we have to learn to pray, since prayer is our first obligation as well as our highest calling. They remind us repeatedly of the words of St. Paul, pray constantly. As one 19th century Russian spiritual writer instructed, make yourself a rule, always be with the Lord, keeping your mind in your heart, and do not let your thoughts wander. As often as they stray, turn them back again, and keep them at home, in the closet of your heart, and delight in converse with the Lord. The great spiritual writers down through the centuries considered a serious discipline necessary to arrive at an intimate relationship with God, while at the same time teaching that prayer is essentially a gift from God, and that we cannot truly pray by ourselves, but that it is God's Spirit that prays in us. We cannot force God into a relationship, however hard we try, but rather God comes to us on his own initiative. Prayer is grace, that is free gift from God, to which we can only respond with gratitude. So the paradox of prayer is that it asks for serious effort, while it can only be received as a gift. We cannot plan, organize, or manipulate God, but without serious discipline, we cannot receive him. As John Mayne, the Benedictine, writes, there is no greater need for the Church and the world today than for a renewed understanding that the call to prayer, to deep prayer, is universal. It's a reminder that every single person, every single one of us, is called to a life of prayer. And at the same time, our prayer cannot simply be focused on ourselves and on our personal relationship with God. Our prayer must extend to the needs of the Church and the world in which we live, and to all the people who inhabit it. We pray not only as individuals, but as a community, as members of the Church. Finally, we all share in the responsibility not only to pray, but to help others to come to a prayerful relationship with God. There are many different ways of praying, and we'll reflect on some of the ways of praying a little later. However, every form of prayer is of value, for they help us to spend time with God in a way that helps us to open our hearts and our minds to his presence, so that we are able to listen to his word. So maybe just to take a few seconds now to reflect on these questions. place of prayer do you find most helpful? In prayer, what helps to allow God to take the initiative? What hinders you from listening to God? To reflect a little on spirituality and prayer. The way we pray reflects our spirituality. Many years ago, if I'd been asked what kind of spirituality I had, I would have replied by saying Ignatian. This would have been because much of what I had learnt up to that point about prayer, I learnt from priests and religious who had immersed themselves in the writing of St. Ignatius of Loyola, and in his spiritual exercises. Now I would say that my spirituality is informed by the spirituality of St. Ignatius, and also by that of St. Teresa of Avila and of St. Benedict. But my spirituality is more than the sum of all of these because it's unique to me. Because ultimately my spirituality is about the way in which I relate to God. The way we pray reflects our spirituality, and therefore the way we pray reflects the way in which we relate to God and the vision we have of God. Our spirituality is unique, and it reflects the life we live. The spirituality of husbands and wives, parents and grandparents will have something in common, because being a parent or a grandparent or a partner has a bearing on the way we relate to other people, and therefore to God. Deacons and priests are members of the family of the diocesan clergy, and share common aspects of their spirituality. This, for example, is reflected in the way they dress, and in the way they serve the parish community, or within their chaplaincy ministry, or the way in which they pray the divine office each day of their lives. Authentic prayer reflects our life and the various ways in which God calls us and we respond. Whoever we are and whatever shape our lives have been given, it is essential that we pray. In prayer, God takes the initiative. When people talk to me about prayer, often they are looking for me to suggest methods or techniques which will help them to pray better. Or in the case of some, they simply want to know how to pray. They want to know what they must do to pray effectively. Such a thirst for knowing how to pray has created libraries of books on prayer, and even I bought a few. Yet the truth, of course, is that the effectiveness of prayer does not depend on us, but rather on God. Prayer, as I said earlier, is not ultimately about what we do, but rather is about what God does. Prayer is a gift. The great Carmelite writer Ruth Burroughs writes, "Almost always when we talk about prayer, we are thinking of something we do, and from that standpoint, questions, problems, confusion, discouragement, illusions multiply. For me, it is of fundamental importance to correct this view. Our Christian knowledge assures us that prayer is essentially what God does, how God addresses us, how God looks at us. It is not primarily something that we do, that we are doing to God, something we are giving to God, but what God is doing for us. And what God is doing for us is giving the divine self in love." The Benedictine John Mayen also says, "All these masters have agreed that in prayer, it is not ourselves who are taking the initiative. We are not looking for him. It is he who has found us. You yourself do nothing. You simply allow him to work in your soul." And of course the great St. Teresa of Avila tells us that all we can do in prayer is to dispose ourselves. The rest is in the power of the Spirit who leads us. It can only be but presumptuous of us to assume that in relating to God in prayer that we'd be expected to take the initiative. At its heart, this act of God is an act of pure and unconditional love. Ruth Boaz again expresses this beautifully when she says, "What is the core, the central message of the revelation of Jesus? Surely it is of the unconditional love of God for us, for each of us, God, the unutterable, incomprehensible mystery, the reality of all reality, the life of all life." And so what's our role? Our role in prayer is to be receptive to God. In prayer, it's God who takes the initiative. However, our role is to make ourselves docile and receptive to God's initiative. This is where learning to pray plays its part. So what do we need to do? Well, firstly, we need to have faith. We need to believe that God is present when we pray, even when we do not experience His prayer, His presence. Prayer is always an act of faith. Secondly, we need to be faithful to our prayer. In other words, we have to have the self-discipline to pray regularly. This means we need to think about our day and to look to a time when we are able to pray. It might only be for 10 minutes, it might be for much longer,